In the crypto world, innovations happen every day. Not long ago, we used to think that if you had some stake, tokens couldn't do anything else but wait for a change in its value while the tokens were static, so to speak. Liquidity mining changes all that. With this feature, traders are rewarded for providing liquidity while they stake their own tokens in a platform such as StakeHound. That's why today we present a very well-known face in our ecosystem, Albert Castellana, CEO of this company, which is now an associate of NEM, that wraps the SEM token into a DeFi-friendly way, opening multiple opportunities for our SEM holders and soon XYM too.
Yes, there's literally billions of dollars in the crypto economy. Most of that is in form of stakes or in DeFi investments. It's huge bucks we're talking about here. Now, how do we get those into the real world economy? And most importantly, how do we get XYM and SEM into that game? To tell us about that, we today present Albert Castellana, CEO of StakeHound, joining us in this NEM show from Spain. Welcome, Albert. Bienvenido to the NEM show.
Gracias, Alexis. Gracias. Thank you for having me here.
No. This is all our pleasure of the whole community to have you here. Now, Albert, lately the hot topic, the currently hot topic, is the liquid staking, which you, of course, as StakeHound, are bringing to our ecosystem. Can you please tell us a bit about StakeHound before we enter into that topic?
Yeah, absolutely. So to give you a bit of context, right? Like we've seen how over the last few years there has been this movement of proof of stake, right? Like NEM was one of the first kind of innovators in the space, but with a proof of importance, and like that's basically a proof of stake mechanism as well. And what we've seen lately is that because of this new hot thing called DeFi, we're going to be talking about later, is actually booming over the last few months. What's happening right now is that there's a fundamental competition between those two, right? Like people have to be choosing, do I want to be participating in staking? Do I want to be, backing the networks that I love? Do I want to be running nodes? Pretty much the same as mining. Or do I want to be participating in this new hot thing that's called DeFi, right? That's like booming. There's people that can make a lot of money from yield farming and lending and borrowing and all these different things, right? So because of this fundamental competition between those two, what's happening is that this trend of liquid staking, what's going to be happening is that it's going to be enabling both of them at the same time, right? You're going to have a representation of a staked asset that is brought into the DeFi space so that it can be transferable while it's still earning rewards, right? So the reason why we do staking is because we want to be securing the networks, right? And in order to secure the networks, you have to have some stake locked up. That stake is actually what's helping the network agree on who should be talking next, right? Who should be voting next? That is very important for networks such as NEM. At the same time, what you want is to be able to use that capital while it's actually securing the network at the same time. That's what we're doing. We're kind of bridging both worlds.
So long story short, it will be like having the best of both worlds, right?
Mm-hmm. That's correct. Yes. I mean, until now, people were just thinking, how can I get the better yield, right? So you can get a lot of yield if you do staking, and you can get a lot of yield if you do DeFi. Can you get yield by staking and then using that while earning yield on DeFi?
How do you foresee NEM working with NEM, with StakeHound? Okay. What benefits do you think StakeHound will bring to our community?
There's quite a few, actually. So if you look right now at the numbers, there's quite a lot of supernodes running, right? There's about 400 supernodes running. Each one of those supernodes require a capital locked of $400,000, about that, $370,000 at this point in time, right? That's actually a lot of capital. That means that a lot of people can't participate in that, right? That means that anyone that doesn't have $400,000 to lock on a supernode, they can get as much yield as if they had a supernode, right? So that is a very strong thing, a very strong motivation for people to hold onto their stem and basically try to see if they can get to that point, right? What we're trying to do is we're trying to democratize that a little bit more, and we're going to be including more people in here. So essentially, a StakeHound is essentially a pool, right, where you're sending your ZEM, you're sending the ZEM in, and then we give back to you a staked ZEM. now, StakeZemi is basically an ERC20 token. That's a token on Ethereum that has the capacity to be distributing the rewards as they come in, right? So we get the ZEM, and then we stake it. And then when we get every single time that we get a reward, we distribute those rewards among the holders of the stake ZEM. Right?
So this you're talking about it's a some sort of wrapping, right?
Yeah, that's really correct. About? We're essentially we're wrapping the ZEM on an ERC20, right? Now, I'm sure you've heard about TrueUSD or Tether, right? Or you have seen something like WrappedBTC. This is essentially the same, but for ZEM, right? And the key thing here is like for the benefits, right? The thing here is that now while people couldn't participate in the SuperNode program, even if you have 10,000 ZEM, you will be able to buy a slice. Let's say, you know, you're gonna buy 10,000 stake ZEM. And then it's essentially as if you had that portion of a SuperNode, right? Other benefits are essentially like participate in DeFi, right? So it's not just like, okay, let's make it so that staking is more inclusive within the NEM ecosystem, but actually now you'll be able to participate in DeFi. What can you do in DeFi? Well, if you have a SuperNode, for example, now you're gonna be able to send it into a lending platform such as Aave, and you're gonna be able to borrow against it, right? So imagine that you have a loan and the collateral, the yield of the collateral, because it's actual staked tokens, is actually paying for the interest of the loan.
And of course, really cool. it opens the door for many other formats. Like it comes to my mind, Uniswap, for instance.
Yeah, totally. I mean,
or many others are jumping into that zone.
We've seen how Uniswap has proven how powerful it is to allow the communities of specific projects to help the projects by providing liquidity. Right, so liquidity is a very important thing. You want to be able to get in and out of any project knowing that there will be other people that will be trading it when you want to get out, essentially, right? And that is something that Uniswap enables very, very effectively through the use of a liquidity pool, what's called, right? Now, on Uniswap right now is the second biggest exchange in crypto, has more daily volume than Coinbase itself. That's Uniswap, right? The way that it works is that anyone can just go in and can deposit two tokens, can deposit, say, StakeZEM and Ether, for example. And then what's going to happen is that when you're depositing those assets, anyone can come in and buy one or the other, right? Essentially, you're enabling the market. You don't need to have an order book-based exchange with its inefficiencies if you have a community that is providing liquidity. And what's going to happen here is that we're going to be helping people, incentivizing people for providing liquidity and creating this market, enabling this market. And why would they do this? Well, essentially because they're going to be getting the fees from all these different trading, right? So now you can essentially, we're democratizing what already like Binance or Coinbase are, so exchanges. Why don't you kind of be a part of an exchange for the communities that you, for the tokens that you love, essentially like enabling those tokens and further, you know, helping their trading, essentially.
But that applies to SEM, actually, right? How about XYM? What can we expect from Symbol? Is this going to be the part of the same alliance? Can you please explain me that, or explain
for
off
sure,
that?
For sure. Yeah. So essentially, what StakeHound is doing is it's creating all these different assets, right? And what we're going to be doing is, by the time that the opt-in kind of finishes, I mean, well, it doesn't finish, but by the time that kind of mainnet comes out, what's going to happen is that we're going to be distributing the staked ZEM to the staked ZEM holders as well, right? So essentially, after the whole period, you will have both tokens, the staked ZEM and the staked ZEM, being live in DeFi. You're going to be able to provide liquidity against them. You're going to be able to provide liquidity for staked ZEM and staked ZEM in a single liquidity pool. It means that anyone will be able to trade much easier from one to the other. There's going to be a bunch of things that will be possible thanks to having both tokens live at that point, right? Essentially, yeah, you're going to see different operations in there. What's interesting to me is seeing like all the different products that are being built on DeFi, right? Like DeFi is very, very fast moving. Like people can come in and can build new protocols that allow for different things, right? You can do something like token sets, for example, where you can have one token that represents multiple things. It's like a basket of different things, right? So you could have a token that essentially has inside, you know, 50% stake ZEM, 50% stake ZIM, and then you have kind of an index of the whole, you know, NEM ecosystem, right? So all these different kind of things that we'll be able to do through DeFi now will no longer become like isolated from NEM. We'll actually, NEM will be in there, right? Like we'll have all these different tools. We'll be able to participate like all these other ERC-20 tokens in the same footing, essentially.
Well, you're going to have an MIA with Ian Wilson, with our Ian Wilson, the CFO of NGL Group, about this very same thing of the alliance with StakeHound. What can we expect there?
So essentially, like what we want to do is for the AMA, we would like to invite the community to kind of join us, right? And like if they have any questions, I mean, this is a complex system, right? Like we're talking that first, DeFi is very nascent and like it's been evolving very quickly. So probably there's going to be a lot of questions on what type of things will you be able to do with StakeZEM or StakeZIM. Then apart from that, like what we'd like to do is basically invite the community to ask us anything that may be, you know, like relevant to this, right? But so essentially, there's going to be a lot of questions on, okay, what does it mean to actually provide liquidity? That's more on the DeFi side of things than on the StakeHound side of things. But at the same time, how can I actually move from my StakeZEM back to ZEM, for example, right? Like how does this operate? Like all these things, I'm sure like we're going to be covering them. So inviting the community to participate. There's another thing that we'd like to highlight, which is that basically, since yesterday, essentially, we started this testnet program where anyone can just like look. You can see on our channel at StakeHound, a link with kind of a document that explains how to do this. But essentially, as of today, you can already go into this website and do the test yourself. Like you can get some StakeZEM, you can trade them, you can provide liquidity for them, kind of all the things that you can do on DeFi, you can already try them on the testnet. And then basically once a day or a couple of times a day, we do these rebases where you can see that actually your balance is changing as the fictional rewards are coming in, essentially, right? So yeah, I'll invite anyone to ask anything on the AMA and like participate on the testnet.
And of course, we invite all the community to join this AMA and ask all the questions. I know you have plenty of them about how to join, of course, NEM and StakeHound as a bridge to the DeFi movement. Also want to invite you all, the community, to join all of our social media and tell us what do you think and who do you want to be in the show. I have to thank Albert for his time here with us, and of course, ask him if he'd be so kind to tell us some words to our community, his community, because he's an important part of the early days of NEM.
Yeah, I mean, I'm very happy to see where NEM has gone. Right, like I joined very early on in my like crypto career. And I've seen it go like through great lengths, and like the understanding now and the community that has been built is absolutely amazing and outstanding, right? I'm very happy to be able to participate again and to be able to help. And yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing like how we can work together again, how the community understands this new product that we're trying to bring to the market, how the community can like start like being engaged with the DeFi space, right? What we've seen lately is that, you know, like it's difficult to understand the DeFi space, especially if you know that it doesn't immediately touch your kind of your ecosystem, right? What we want to do is we want to be educating people so that people understand, okay, what is DeFi? What are the benefits of this? Some things are good, some things are bad. And like, you know, all this like road will be very, very interesting. I'm really looking forward to this, and I couldn't be happier and more thankful, you know, for you and the NEM group to have like given us this opportunity to be able to work together towards this effort.
Not at all, Albert. Thank you for being here. Well, that's all for this episode of the NEM Show. My name is Alexis Trujillo, and of course, stay tuned for more news on the NEM ecosystem. See you all, guys. Thank you, Albert. Muchas gracias.
Gracias, Alexis. Hasta pronto. Adiós.